Victoria's state of emergency has been extended for another 4 weeks, giving the Chief Health Officer power to enforce mask wearing and future lockdowns. The move comes as Melburnians are warned against COVID complacency, with another outbreak all but certain.
After 71 days of no community cases in Victoria, many of us feel comfortable in crowds. But in Sydney, it's a different story. While there are no new local cases, there's a crackdown on suburbs with a suspected link to a mystery case.
We're obviously concerned, and that's why we've added the precautions around wearing masks and increased the level of restrictions.
In Melbourne, masks are only mandatory on public transport, but experts fear it may be only a matter of time before a major outbreak.
We're a sneeze away from another disaster if we're not careful. We're not getting vaccinated. We've stopped wearing masks. We aren't checking into places like we used to with the QR codes.
The longer since our last local outbreak, the less front of mind it is for people.
But screening for the virus remains high. Yesterday, 18,000 Victorians got tested.
Even if you think it just feels like a normal cold, still get tested.
Globally, the pandemic is worse than it's ever been.
Cases are surging in almost every single country. It's awesome to be in a zero COVID state, but without it here, yes, complacency is a big factor. 20% of people are not keen to get a vaccine, and that is a concern.
Despite detecting and declaring the Indian strain of the virus a concern, England is lifting an international travel ban in just over a week. Australia is on their green list, allowing quarantine-free travel, but there are a few red flags. Stopover countries remain blacklisted, Aussies are still under an international travel ban, and returning travellers would face 14 days in hotel quarantine, a system that remains our front line of defence, guarding us against an outbreak.
And Estelle Griepink has the latest vaccine numbers. And Estelle, Victorians are being urged to book in for the jab.
Well, Mike, our numbers are on the rise, but health authorities want to see even more. We've now surpassed more than 250,000 vaccinations. Almost 8,000 of those were done yesterday. It is expected that our clinics will be a little more quiet tomorrow for Mother's Day, but that may be the perfect time for those aged 50 and over to get the jab. Mike?
Yes.